please subscribe and don't forget to press the bell icon to get notified whenever we upload a new video.
We have Jinesh Gopani, fund manager at Axis Mutual Fund, who's now with us on the show. Jinesh, thanks very much. Good morning. Good to have you here. So what is the in sort of mutual fund perspective as far as this market correction is concerned? You know, first of all, if you can tell us if there have been, in this fall, has there been any requests for redemption, you know, at any meaningful level at your fund or in the industry, if you're aware of it? And second, what have you been doing in this fall?
Yeah, hi, Prashant. From the mutual fund point of view, I don't think we are into a situation where there is a request on redemption. The flow still continues to be decent and strong. But it's too early to say. We'll have to see how this volatility is being digested by the market participants and the investors. And we'll have to wait for 2-3 months and really see whether the market is volatile, stabilizes, or is further going down. So I think it's too early or premature to say that the flows or the redemptions are coming by. Mm.
You know, typically, do redemptions happen when market doesn't perform, or when the market goes down quite a bit? I mean, when people actually start losing money. Is that a necessary condition?
No, I think... See, it is very difficult to gauge the mind of an investor, why he would have invested and what makes him sell. So it's very difficult for me or anyone to gauge that. But normally, if there is an event which leads to a significant negative impact on the market, and let's say an investor is a new investor who has just entered, let's say, 6 months back or four months back, and is not a high risk taker guy. So you would see those kind of people maybe calling in for redemption if there is an event which is negative. But by and large, it's very difficult to give you any reason, particular reason why the redemptions can come.
Jinesh, hi, morning. What's the house call on IT now? Are you buying?
Morning. So I think incrementally, as I've been saying, we will keep on looking, and if the businesses are seeing some traction, definitely would like to add some good stories. If we feel that the 7-8% growth trajectory is going to, let's say, double digit kind of a growth. So as of now, it's not going that way, and the numbers have been okay. But the commentaries have been much better. Also, I think IT as a sector is more a hedge against the domestic economic sectors. So maybe to some extent, if we feel that the domestic sectors are not doing well, then obviously we'll have some allocation going into those sectors.
Mm-hmm. Any sector, I mean, so just to come back to the second part of my first question, which is, what have you been doing? Any sectors in which you've moved significantly in or out?
So nothing significant. I think the result season was there, so we were trying to analyze our portfolio earnings, and as of now, it stands good. So we are okay with that. Having said that, obviously, if you feel that there could be some kind of a positioning which can be done in the technology type sectors, obviously, we would like to move some money that side.
Okay. So, what's the view on banks now, Jinesh? Because that's been, you know, the worst performing sector for the month of February for obvious reasons. What part of financials are you still interested in buying or holding?
So as we have done for last 8 years, we are more cautious on banks which are, let's say, not properly governed, or the risk parameters don't fit in our universe. So we have been always bullish on private sector banks, especially a bank who has a granular business of retail That is where we have been betting our bets for last many years, and we would continue to do that going forward.
Fair enough. Jinesh, you know, what is the big sort of worry from here? I mean, in a way, you said that new investors will be tested over the next few months, right? So this is and most people seem to believe that what happens from here will be a little tougher than earlier episodes where markets corrected and they were bought back very, very quickly. This may not be one of those. Is it politics? We've got state elections coming up. What is going to be the big worry?
So I think it is a mix of both domestic and global events. Everything has come together. If you see, LTCG has come in, which has put some brakes on the market. You have budget, which is more. There is a concern about fiscal deficit now because of the lower GST collection. The US GSEC rates are at 2.9 odd levels. So if that breaks 3%, then you will have global rout, which will have its own impact on the Indian markets. So I think everything has come together, and please don't forget you are going into a political season. So see, decibel levels will be very high in terms of news flows, good or bad. So that will have its own volatility for the market. So I think it will be more volatile over next 3 to 6 months. It depends on many events which unfolds, and we have to be careful on that.